What's up, YouTube? Israel Barron, a quick video. Well, today I got another unboxing, first impressions, and update video. So this fragrance has been getting a lot of positive attention in Fragcom. It was officially released today, so I went by and picked one up. So this fragrance is the latest release from the House of Coach. It is a flanker from the very successful 2017 release, Coach for Men. From the House of Coach, New York, it is Coach Platinum. Alright guys, so Coach Platinum is a 2018 release. It's considered an oriental woody. It is an eau de parfum concentration, and the nose behind this fragrance is Bruno Jovanovic. Let's take a look at the presentation. Alright guys, so here is the box for Coach Platinum. Sorry for any reflection there, but this is a pretty basic box. I mean, it's platinum colored here. It has some, almost some lines looking like some, almost looks like metal going across there. It does say 100ml here, eau de parfum concentration. The top does have some texture in it, almost looks like a leather kind of look on it. But other than that, not too much going on with this box. Just a little bit of information at the bottom here, but that's about it. All right, so here is the bottle for Coach Platinum. Has a few things going on with it here. Has like a leather looking band going across here, kind of holding this keychain looking thing. It says Coach on it, if you can see that. It says Coach right there. There is the horse-drawn coach, as you can see. The bottle's completely silver. Little information on the bottom, it tells you the size. And that's really about it. There's no caps with these bottles, which I don't know if I like or not. This comes like a little piece of plastic here to cover it up. But I kind of wish that this had a cap on it. All right guys, so here are the notes for Coach Platinum. In the top we have black pepper, pineapple, and juniper berry. In the mid we have cashmerian, sage, and geranium. And in the base we have leather, patchouli, vanilla, and sandalwood. All right guys, I really don't know what to expect from this fragrance. I did sort of like the one that was released last year, Coach for Men. It had a really nice opening, but there was a sour note in that. Not sure what note that came from. There was no ambroxan or ginger or anything like that in it. But there was a sour note that I did not like from the Coach fragrance. But it got a lot of good feedback and people really enjoyed it. So I imagine this was going to be nice. So the notes in this that actually had me really excited to want to try it were the pineapple, the juniper berry, the leather, vanilla, and the sandalwood. All right guys, let's take a few sprays and see if this one's any good. All right guys, clean arm, take a couple sprays. Sprayer's okay. Okay. Definitely an oriental woody, one of my favorite classifications, by the way. Another reason why I was really excited to try this one. Yeah, definitely getting the fruity pineapple. Definitely getting the vanilla. Definitely getting the woods. So right now it's a creamy, woody, sweet vanilla pineapple. I'm guessing the juniper berries are in there too because I'm getting a fruity note. So it's probably just not the pineapple that I'm picking up. Now I gotta say, off the first impressions, off the initial smell, this one kind of reminds me a little bit of Polo Red Extreme. That one has vanilla, ebony woods, and some coffee notes. There's no coffee in this, but I'm definitely getting that sweet vanilla with the woods in it. Wow, yeah, this one's nice though. This one's right up my alley. It's sweet, it's woody, it's fruity. You know, I'm not getting the leather yet. I'm picking up the sandalwood. Little bit of the patchouli, but right now I'm definitely getting the fruit notes, the juniper berries, the pineapple. The black pepper's making a little bit spicy. Yeah, so I've got to be honest with you. I do love oriental woody fragrances, and this one is an oriental woody, so I like this one. I got to say that I do like it right off the top. Obviously, I can't say too much more about it because it's still early on in this process, but right now I do like it. I'm a sucker for sweet, woody, fruity fragrances, and that's exactly what I'm getting out of this one. This is an eau de parfum, so I guess I'll update you guys in a little bit, let you know how long it lasts. Lately here, these designers, though, have been saying it's an eau de parfum or an intense or all these other monikers, and they haven't really been living up to the title, so... Yeah, it's starting to change a little bit. I'm starting to get almost like a mintiness or something coming out of this one. I'm not really sure what that comes from. There's a bit of a freshness coming out in this one. But yeah, right now, this one smells pretty good. It is changing away from the opening a little bit. Not sure what direction it's going. But like I said, I'm getting a little bit of something cooling to my nose. Something that's in there is kind of giving it a cooling effect. Almost like a menthol or something. Not sure. Maybe I'm just overthinking it, but... The woods are starting to come in a lot stronger now. So I'm not really sure what that's going to do in an hour or so. But it's definitely masculine. It's definitely has a masculine touch to it. I'm not going to say this one is completely original or it's completely blowing me away, but I do like it. I can give you that much. I do enjoy it. I like it depending on how long it lasts and the projection. I think it should be a people pleaser. I mean, this is along the lines of like a club fragrance because, you know, a lot of those club fragrances are very sweet and very very woody and very sweet and have, you know, they're just, the masses love those fragrances. Yeah. So right now, yeah, it's getting a lot woodier. Maybe it's the black pepper that's kind of giving the woods a little more bite to it because the woods are getting very woody and like spicy and woody and sort of dark. But all in all, I still get that vanilla. It's not as sweet as it was on the initial spray, but it's still there. So the vanilla is still sort of evening things out. But I imagine that after a while, the woods are going to kick in even stronger. The pepper's going to be more pronounced and the vanilla is going to go into the background. But obviously, I'll let you guys know that. All right, guys, so far I'm impressed with this one, but obviously we need to give a little bit more time. So as usual, I'm going to go with my 8 to 10 sprays, wear it out this evening, give you guys an update in a little bit. Talk to you then. All right, guys, so I'm back with my update for Coach Platinum. It's been about 6 hours. The fragrance is still there, but it's barely detectable, and I went with pretty heavy sprays. Like I said, I think I went 8 to 10. If not, I might have gone a couple more. It was really hot outside. In the first few hours, it projected really well. You know, 3 to 4 hours, I could still smell it coming off me. But for an audit parfum concentration, it didn't boom as much as I thought it would. In the first half of the video, I believe I said it'd make a good club fragrance. The opening smells like it would make a good club fragrance. It's very sweet with the vanilla and some of the woods, and it's spicy from the pepper, but like it dies down quite a bit after the first hour and a half, 2 hours, you know, something like that. And it kind of, the vanilla kind of goes away. You can still get some of the vanilla in the background, so it's sort of like a slightly sweet, kind of woody, spicy fragrance after the initial hour, but it doesn't stay as sweet and as loud as the opening. So don't know if it'll be good for clubs. Maybe if you're only going to the club for a little while, will it make a good club scent? For an eau de parfum concentration, I figured it would last a lot longer. But overall, the smell is still really nice. I really enjoyed the opening. The first 3 hours of this fragrance, I really, really enjoyed. After that, it sort of just got slightly sweet and kind of peppery. The green notes came out. The sage really started coming out. Around the second hour, 2.5 hours, got a little barbershop-ish. Just a little bit. A little fougere-ish in there. I guess that was the sage that did that as well. Made it smell a little barbershop-y, but not overpowering at all. I just picked it up and sort of in there, you know, here and there. But like it sort of went away from that opening that I really liked and sort of turned to a green fragrance a little bit. So it was slightly sweet, slightly spicy, and got a little greener as time went by, which isn't a bad thing. It just went away from the opening, which I really enjoyed. All right, so is this a buy, try, or pass? I would say try this one. If you're gonna be at the mall, you know, go ahead and give it a try, guys. You know, see what it's about. Maybe even buy it. I think it's pleasant enough. It's safe enough to wear at work. It's safe enough to wear on a date. It's not that loud to where it's gonna offend people like if it was a club fragrance. So in that aspect, it actually works better. It's more wearable. You can wear it at more places. But yeah, if you're looking for a strong club scent, this isn't gonna be it. It is very pleasant though. I don't think it's gonna be offensive. You're definitely not gonna make anybody angry or get in anybody's space with this fragrance. It smells pleasant. I like it. I'm not gonna say I'm blown away by it. I'm not gonna say it's like the next best thing, the next best hype monster or anything like that. For a designer fragrance, it is good. I'll give it that much. I'll stick with my opening thoughts on it, which was that it was really good. I liked it. Didn't last as long as I would like, so that kind of, you know, lost a few points to me on that one. I wish for an eau de parfum concentration it would last a lot longer. I'm thinking 8 to 10 hours. At least let the vanilla, you know, be like still be there strong, but it didn't. I would recommend trying this one for sure, you know. And if you have, you know, a gift card or some extra money you just want to blow on a new fragrance, definitely pull the trigger on this one. I think it's worth a shot. But yeah, definitely try it. If you know, you can go to a Macy's or Dillard's. I bet they have testers of these, and give it a try and see what you think about it. Like I said, it didn't last as long as I wanted to. So, you know, for the money, it's about $100 for 100 mil after tax. So $100, 6 hours of wear on this one. It's really up to you on if you want to pull the trigger or not, guys. All right, guys, those are my thoughts on Coach Platinum. Have you tried Coach Platinum? Do you like it? Do you love it? Do you hate it? Let me know down in the comments below. All right, guys, thanks for watching another video on my channel. If you like this video and want to see more videos like it, please give me a thumbs up. Please follow me on Instagram, $. Please like, comment, subscribe. Until the next video, you guys take care. Thanks.